In today's video, I'm going to show you step by step how to calculate your macronutrients for sustainable fat loss. Stay tuned. Hey guys, what's going on? Shane Hubbard Fit. Thanks for watching this video today. If you are new to my channel, don't forget to hit subscribe before you leave if you enjoyed the video today. And then if you're a returning subscriber, thanks for tuning in. You're gonna get a ton of value in today's video. All right, so just so we make sure that everyone is in the right place, this video is going to be for beginners. If you're new to counting your macronutrients and keeping track of your macronutrients and calculating your macros for sustainable fat loss, you are in the right place. This is the perfect video for you. If you're someone who has experience with this and maybe you've done this in the past and had success, or maybe you just wanna kind of look at some new ways of thinking about this, this is also a good video for you, but you might wanna skip around a little bit because we're gonna go into some pretty gritty detail about how to calculate your macros for sustainable fat loss. So if that all sounds good to you, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button and we'll get started right away. All right, so before we dive right into all of the juicy content, I wanna go over some terms to help make this even easier for you to understand. The very first term is gonna be macros or macronutrients. What the heck are macronutrients? Well, it's just a kind of a fancy or a scientific way of saying proteins, carbs, and fats. And those are the types of foods that you're going to be paying attention to when we're in a caloric deficit. It's also the percentages you're going to calculate in this video to get your calorie deficit and to also make sure you're keeping track of your macronutrients. All right, so the next term is calorie maintenance. So your calorie maintenance is how much you eat and burn to keep your weight the exact same. So if I eat 2,000 calories and I burn 2,000 calories, then I'm essentially going to have a calorie maintenance, which means that I'm not going to lose weight and I'm not going to gain weight. So we need to know that first, and we're going to figure that out in a couple of moments in this video. All right, so the last term is a calorie deficit. A calorie deficit is the holy grail of fat loss. We're going to be calculating that today. Essentially, what your calorie deficit is, taking your calorie maintenance number and subtracting a certain amount of calories from it to get a calorie deficit. Okay, cool. So now that we've gotten that figured out and we got some terminology down, let's go ahead and dive right into your calorie maintenance. So to figure out your calorie maintenance, the very first thing we have to do is we have to know what your current weight is. So if you don't know your weight, pause this video, go weigh yourself really quick and come back. All right, so now that you know your body weight, you're going to take your body weight, that whole number, and you're gonna multiply it by 13. You're gonna get this big number. You're more than likely going to use a calculator for this. So once you take your weight and multiply it by 13, write that number down and save it. All right, so now that we know our calorie maintenance, what we have to do next is figure out our calorie deficit. So this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna take your calorie maintenance number and you're gonna subtract 350 calories from that to give you a calorie deficit number. All right, so now that you have your calorie deficit, we can dive right into our macronutrient splits. Before we go into our specific macronutrient splits, there's a couple of principles I wanna make sure you understand. So before we get started on the exact macronutrient split that I'm going to give you, I wanna make sure you understand a couple of principles with macronutrients so that you have sustainable fat loss. The very first one is keep protein high. You wanna have about 25 to 30% of your total calories coming from protein at all times, right? When we are in a calorie deficit, we are going to get hungry. And one of the best ways to suppress our appetite in a healthy and sustainable manner is going to be through eating enough protein. We also want to be able to maintain our muscle mass going forward. And when you're in a calorie deficit, it's a lot harder to do that. So by getting enough protein, you make it so that your body doesn't burn protein, instead burns body fat, and you keep the muscle mass on your body that you currently have and that you're trying to continue to build. All right, so the second principle is adjust your carbs and fats to your preference. A lot of people think that you have to be on a low carb diet to lose fat, or that fat is going to make you fat. And the truth of the matter is, when you look at the studies that have been done on carbs and fats and how they affect fat loss, there really is no specific macronutrient split or anything like that that works for everyone. You kind of have to adjust things and do what works for you. So once you get in the kind of the rhythm of your macronutrient split and you start doing things, if you want to adjust your carbs here, adjust your fats there, that's totally cool. You want to find something that works really good for you. When I have clients come on board and they start working with me, we spend a lot of time making sure that they have a calorie split and a macro split that works really well for them. Because if they don't, it's gonna be really hard to sustain fat loss over time. All right, so the third principle is going to be making sure that you get at least 15 grams of fiber every single day. All right, so just like protein, you wanna keep kind of your protein at a certain amount every single day. You wanna keep your fiber at about 15 grams a day. Again, this is gonna be super beneficial for sustaining fat loss over time, because when we are trying to lose body fat, our appetite is going to be something we have to manage very closely. And fiber can help make you feel full longer in between meals so you don't get cravings. And cravings when you're trying to lose fat are the biggest enemy you can have. All right, so at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and put the calorie or the macro split on the video. It's gonna be 25% protein, 35% carbs, and then 40% fat. And that's a good starting point. If you're a beginner, you don't know what kind of macronutrient split to have, use this macronutrient split. I'm gonna put it in the description down below so you can use it there as well. That way you can get started and you can make adjustments later on if you need to. All right, the last step in this entire process is really up to you, but I wanna give you some guidelines on how to make this work best for you. So now that you have your calorie deficit and now that you have a macro split that works for you, you actually have to test it. So the first thing you wanna do is you wanna take your current weight and you wanna record that. Then you wanna eat to this macronutrient split and this calorie deficit that you've created during this video as consistently as you can, up to 80% or even 100% if you really have that ability, for at least 1 to 2 weeks. And you wanna weigh yourself once a week, maybe twice a week, seeing kind of how things are going. And if you're not losing body fat and if you're not losing weight on the scale of some kind and maybe you feel like crap or it's not really working for you, you have to adjust your calorie deficit a little bit more than that. So this is what you do if you're not losing body fat. You wanna decrease your calorie deficit by another 50 to 100 calories, all right? Try 50 first. If it feels like you can do 100, do 100, but that's about as far as you wanna go. You don't wanna create a huge calorie deficit where it's like you can never get out of it, so to speak. You wanna create enough of a deficit so that you can separate yourself from your calorie maintenance, burn body fat without being miserable the entire time and being overly restrictive, okay? So that is those tips for adjusting and kind of making tests here and there and seeing how your body reacts. All right, guys, so that is my video today on how to calculate your macronutrients for sustainable fat loss. Thanks again for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up before you leave. Subscribe to this channel or subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you want to get more videos just like this, they're going to help walk you through how to lose body fat. And as always, guys, if you have any comments, questions, concerns, or you just want to say hi, don't forget to write your comment down in the comment section down below. All right, guys, that's it for me today. Thanks for tuning in. I will see you in a future video.